got the Jacob Blake up criminal complaint. This was found by my man, Mr. Singh, so kudos to you once again. I just wanted to cover this real quick because I hadn't seen it. I'm going to link it. It's a PDF, so I'll link it in the comments section if you want to read the whole thing for yourself. I'm not going to read the whole thing, but we just want to get a good idea of who this guy is. Count number one, criminal trespass and domestic abuse. Count number two, third degree assault with some sexual component, domestic abuse. And let's read a little bit more about that one. Did have intercourse with Ellen B., that's the initials of the individual, the victim, without that person's consent. Contrary to, and then they name the section codes in Wisconsin law, the Class G felony upon conviction may be fined not more than $25,000 or imprisoned not more than 10 years or both. On the first charge, the criminal trespass, domestic abuse, a little bit more minor, you know, in terms of the sentencing. It says here, could be fined not more than $10,000 or imprisoned not more than 9 months or both. There's a third count here, disorderly conduct and domestic abuse. It says here that Blake did engage in violent, abusive, indecent, profane, boisterous. Oh my God, how many words are they going to use to describe it? You get the picture. So it's a Class B misdemeanor upon conviction, may be fined not more than $1,000 or imprisoned not more than 90 days or both. Maybe they should have led with the old assault charge at the top, right? Put number one up at the top. Give me your best thing at the top. Well, let's get into a little PC though real quick and then we'll wrap this up. But there's some interesting things here. An officer who came out to the scene. Okay, so first of all, it says here, the ex, Blake, had broken into the residence, stole some vehicle keys, a vehicle, and a debit card from the victim before fleeing. Now, according to the witness, she had rented the vehicle, but here, I'll skip down to the third paragraph, stated at about 6 a.m. she was woken up by the father of her children, Jacob Blake, herein known as the defendant, standing over her saying, "I want my shirt." As L and B was laying there on her back, the defendant suddenly and without warning reached his hand between her legs, penetrated her lady spot with a finger, pulled it out and sniffed it, and said, "Smells like you've been with other men."
I was like, "What that smell like?" She was like, she didn't know what to say. I'm like, "Don't make me ask you again."
You guys ever hear that song? I can't recall. I don't know how long ago it was, but it was something. It was a female singing, and she'd say, "Let me smell your dick." Yeah, I'm not a singer. There was a song like that, really. Terrible. Terrible. And my singing of it was probably even worse than the song. Look it up. I don't want to. I'm tempted to. I might. The officer had said LBN had a difficult time telling him this and cried as she told how the defendant assaulted her, and then the defendant immediately left the bedroom. Stated that the defendant penetrated her digitally, caused her pain and humiliation, and was done without her consent.
Unforgivable.
LBN stated that she was upset, but collected herself and ran after the defendant out the front door and realized her vehicle was missing. She came back inside, I guess her purse, which was on the kitchen counter, checked it, realized the key for her truck was missing. A black individual key. Black individual key. So easy. I'm just reading what's here. And the only key for the vehicle and her Great Lakes debit card were missing. We skip ahead a little bit. It says they have three children together, but have never resided together in 8 years. They have been on and off. LNB stated the defendant is unemployed, has no vehicle, and would not tell LNB where he is currently living. LNB stated over the past 8 years, the defendant has physically assaulted her around twice a year when he drinks heavily. I'm not laughing at that, but I'm just thinking about twice. Like, it's such a specific number. He just, twice a year, just, what is it, like his birthday and his semi, what, his mid-birthday? He just says, "Oh, let me get liquored up and go beat the ex." All right. That's just a little bit about Jacob. Now, I'm going to say this with some delicacy, because I don't want to downplay the assault, but when I hear individuals talking, and I may have done this too with before seeing this, when I heard individuals talking about, oh, he's a predator, this and that, I had something else in mind, to be quite honest. I kind of went to the worst place. I went to the worst place mentally, and I made a lot of assumptions. Now, that being said, with what he did, with all of these things that he did, I can't imagine him getting that much time. I think that that's just how the system would work. The third count, they'd probably drop it. They'd probably get him to take a plea on the second count in offering to drop the first count. That's just what it is. They probably would try to get him to plea out on the second count. Maybe a hefty fine. Doesn't have a job, so how is he going to pay it? For this specific set of crimes, may not come down on him too hard. Now, we've got the new charges and assault on a police, whatever happened at the scene that day, whatever commotion he was causing with these individuals. It looked like he was trying to take the vehicle again, perhaps. There's the knife involved. So, like I said yesterday, he is going to be, if proven guilty, innocent until proven guilty, he'd be one of the richer guys on the tier based on the payout he's probably going to get due to the fact that at this point, it looks like he's not going to be able to walk anymore. We'll see how that progresses, obviously. That's just a little bit more about Jacob Blake. So the final thing I would add, and just wrap this up real quick, and I alluded to it a bit yesterday in some comments, was this is the guy that they chose to martyr. How do you come back from this? A cynical person might say, oh, well, he just fingered her a little bit. You know, I did more than that in high school. Yeah, well, it was against her will. And he beat her, allegedly. So how do you come back from supporting an individual like this? How do you get there where they did stuff in baseball? Hockey, I heard. The women to try to throw the basketball in the hoop. The NBA? They're talking about giving up millions of dollars, possibly. Calling off their season for this guy? How do you ever come back from this? If you're willing to defend this guy, if you're willing to defend somebody like Floyd, and we're talking about the black athlete, entertainers, those individuals that are kind of in this type of group where they come out every time a black person shot. If you're willing to side with this guy, how do you not come out every single time a black person shot? By police or not, when this is the hill you die on, so to speak, how do you not come out every single time? Because you're going to look like a hypocrite. Every single time people do this, they get made to look stupid because more information comes out. We see the record. We see they're a scumbag. When you're crying wolf and you've done it so many times, it gets old. We tune it out. NBA players were trying to say, oh, we feel like our message is getting lost. That's because your message sucks. You don't have a message. You support criminals. Simple as that. When you support criminals, we tune it out because it's bullshit. We know it's bullshit. It's unfortunate that they're too stupid to know it's bullshit. Where do they go from here? Every single time, we're going to expect a tweet from all of these individuals. What does a guy have to do for you not to support him? Say he killed his three kids and his baby mama. And then that part happened with the cops. Would they still side with him? I bet they would. You got to keep cranking it up, right? 10's not enough. Got to crank it up to 11, 12, 13. Where does it end? You can't stop. It just keeps going and going. It's going to keep getting worse and worse. They're going to keep coming out every single time. All right, everybody. Let me know what you think. Take care. And thanks for watching.